universal negative, I meant particular affirmative and O meant particular negative. What were they? They are nothing but the constituent sentences of an argument. An argument will consist of statements, and those statements can be of different kinds. In that, we had specifically picked up categorical propositions. And we spoke of all men are creative, all human beings are creative. No human beings are creative. We look at the format. This has a typical format. Syllogisms. If you see your syllabus, there's a topic called syllogism. We spoke of different kinds of syllogism that can be. And a syllogism is an inference where you need a linking term. So if I have to say all students are present here, this person is a student in this room, this person is, this person is here, so this person is a student. So we link it up. That is how we had done in the last class. And further we did the kind of propositions which make up an argument will tell you what kind of argument it is. We said there could be one sentence like this. If I come late, the class will be dismissed. I have come late, therefore the class is dismissed. So I had a condition there. The condition was coming late. What was the result? Class would be dismissed. I affirmed I came late, therefore the class was dismissed. Now these are arguments which are having related statements. Related statements. So similarly, we spoke of arguments of syllogism, a kind of syllogism. We are talking of categorical propositions, and we are talking of categorical syllogism. That means they need to be simple, assertive sentences. Simple, assertive sentences, which are classified on the basis of the reference they make. If they are referring to the whole class, they are called as universal. If they are referring to part of the class, they are called as particular. If they are affirmative or they are positive, they are called as affirmative. And if they are denying something, they are called as negative. So putting those two principles together and the four varieties that we get four kinds of proposition. A stands for universal, affirmative. E stands for universal, negative. I stands for particular, affirmative. And O stands for particular negative. And each of these could be drawn with the help of two circles. And we show the relation between the two terms. So every sentence has will consist of a subject about which we are speaking, and it will have a predicate. So let's look at the first one. All humans are creative. The whole set of human beings are fitting into the whole set of creative beings. In this, no humans are creative. I'm still referring to the whole set of human beings, but what? They're excluded from creativity. So here there is a relation of total inclusion of the subject in the predicate. All human beings are creative. So I'm taking the whole set of humans, putting them in the creative. Here I'm saying no humans are creative, so you are excluding the whole set of human beings from what? The whole set of creative beings. Then you have some. So obviously all of us know that it will be an intersecting circle. Intersecting circles, and we are referring to this part. That is, some humans are creative. And the last one is also intersection of circle. But the difference is here we are excluding these many human beings from the whole set of creative beings. And we identify these whenever the reference is complete or total, we use the technical word distribution. We said a term whenever it refers to the entire class, it is said to be distributive. So we also understood this in the last class when we said A distributes its subject, E distributes both the terms, I distributes none, and O distributes very. This is where we had stopped in the last
class. What do you mean distributes?
Distributes means when I'm making a reference to the whole class. There's a technical word. There are two aspects to any given proposition. It may be affirming something. Like for example, I'm saying all humans are created. What am I affirming about the human beings? That they are created. How many human beings am I referring to?
All.
The moment I refer to the entire class, it is said to be distributed. In the sense, whenever a word in its quantitative aspects, denotation we call it, refers to the entire class, it is said to be distributed. That's a technical word. Actually, you just need to remember reference is total, complete, yes. How much? Like if you were to draw a boundary line, what is the extent of the word? Suppose you say black. Question is the degree of how black. Is it jet black, grayish black, little? So that question comes. But when you say, suppose you're going to say student, how many students are you including? You're not asking who are the students, you're saying how many students are you including? Are you referring to some students of this particular class? Are you referring to all the students? So when the moment you say all the students, what are you doing? You're referring to the entire class. So distribution means a term. Term would mean what? A subject term or a predicate term. When it refers to the entire class. So if I say all students in this class are smart, I'm referring to each and every one being smart. I say some students in this class are smart, we don't know how many they are. But at least in logic it means one. There is at least one student in this class who is smart. Are we clear on this? Subject. He distributes both subject and predicate. Both. Yes.
Both
means subject and predicate. Subject and predicate of what? Of a proposition. Premise number 1, premise number 2, putting these two together, we arrived at premise number 3, not premise, sorry, proposition number 3, and that's conclusion. Now we're moving on to what SPM means. Okay. What's the subject of the conclusion? A. All of you can identify that? Yes. Subject of the conclusion? Yes. Subject of the conclusion is A. I'm putting the symbol S here. What's the predicate of the conclusion?
P.
Same. So I've got my SP here. Okay. Are we there? Now identify.
Identify SP part.
S is the subject of the conclusion.
And the premise.
Where is it visible in the premise? Where is it visible in the premise? In this one.
The third one. All C is equal to
A. Yes.
You can also say, yeah, all C is equal to A.
That's the conclusion.
Yeah, so in that case, C would have been subject and A is predicate?
No, no, no. So which one?
If we mention in the conclusion, we have mentioned here A, all A is equal to C. We could have also mentioned all C is equal to A.
But that will not follow it.
A is B, B is C, so C is A.
I think. Okay, I'll write it here.
It's my alphabet.
यहाँ पर परमानेंट क्यों लगा है कोई गेट अ पर्पल वन
Now, as per standard format of a syllogistic argument, which says your major premise should be first, then your minor premise, and then the conclusion.
So you rework on this.
You rework on this, and what would you do?
Change the order.
So to change the order, I am wiping this off the minor premise. I write over here all, what is it? A is
C.
B.
C. B. Sorry, B.
B. Okay. Now I write my conclusion as all A is C. So my subject of the conclusion is still the minor term, the predicate is still the major term, but the position of the premise has changed. Are we there?
Yes.
Did we all get that? That we've changed the order of the premise? We arrived at minor premise. In the last class, we also spoke of what is called as a linking term, a term which links the two premises, and that was called the middle term, or symbolized by the letter N. Which will that be?
B.
B. Because that's the only one which is common in both. This will not be visible in the conclusion. Are we clear to you? So we've done the first set of rules of syllogism. The first set of rules says, rule of structure, it is called as rule of structure. It says there should be only three terms. What are the three terms? Just now we spoke about it. S as the minor term, P as the major term, and M as the middle term. Let's take two examples. I've just brought some examples for you all. And I've given you the cards because I want you all to write on that S, P, N.
Cards.
Yeah. You have blank ones, pass it. So you have six cards, each of you should have. Each of you should have six. And please write S. Two cards you need to write S. You need more? I have plenty.
Two cards S.
Only you take six. Though S, two S on two cards write S, two cards you write the letter P, and two cards write the letter M. Anyone else? Okay.
S, two P, N?
Two N's.
Same
color as S. Keep the color combination in a manner. If you don't have, it's okay. To just highlight that you know the S's are in one color, predicate is in one color. You need more? S twice, the letter P twice, and the letter M twice. Anyone needs? Now I'll read out an example. You quickly put, if you want, you may take down the example so that it's easier for you to. Here. Okay, let's take an example. It's better if it is a different color, sir. If not, choice is yours. Choice is yours. Okay. Are we there?
Yeah.
Can we quickly take down this example? All lawyers are
liars.
Ketan sir, no. All lawyers are liars.
True or false?
No, we are not on the fact.
Universal truth.
Okay, the next one. Mr. A is a lawyer. Mr. A is a lawyer. Therefore, Mr. A is a lawyer. So all of us have got three propositions. Your conclusion was, therefore Mr. A is liar. Now quickly identify S, P, M in the given argument. So identify, what's your conclusion?
Mr. A is a liar.
So where will you put the letter S?
Subject A. Mr. A.
Is your S. First S is Mr. A. Where will be your letter P?
Liar.
Liar.
No, lawyer.
Liar.
Liar.
Middle
now,
term is lawyer.
Middle term is
lawyer. This is joining term.
Joining term, correct.
Yes.
Middle
all
term
lawyers
is lawyer.
Are liars. Slip your A a lawyer. That's visible in both, not in the
lawyer.
Now, can we put it in order? You have your major premise, minor premise, and conclusion. What will be your major premise? All lawyers are liars. So, your major premise should have all lawyers. Your middle term first. It will be this format.
Madam, major premise will be Mr. A is a lawyer, no?
No, sir. You got all lawyers are liars. Mr.
A is
a lawyer.
Lawyer cancel.
Yeah, okay. Right.
What was the conclusion? Mr. A is
a liar.
Right. I'm sure all of you have written this and you would have got this in this format. Your answer should be like this.
Right.
This is your letter S. This is your letter P.
Yes.
Lawyer is M.
Lawyer is
M.
Perfect. Now you would have got this format if you have kept the cards in the right manner. It would be MP.
Yes.
SM.
Yes.
SM. Did you all get this?
Yes.
Okay. Any doubt?
Perfect.
So? Did you get this order? Anyone who's not got it or has got it differently? Clear? Can we take one more example and quickly you will re-look at this? All cats are animals. All animals are carnivorous. Animals are carnivorous. Maybe it's not a fact. All animals are carnivorous.
Cat is a
cat. That's correct. All cats are carnivorous. Now quickly put that order of SP in there.
Animal is
animals.
SMMP SP.
Okay, wait, let me write it down. It's very important for me to write down what you're saying.
SM?
Yep.
MP, SP.
What did you say, sir? S?
SM.
SM.
MP.
SM. How many of you got this as an answer?
MP.
Very good. This is the correct answer. Did you all get this?
Yes.
Anyone has a doubt as to why this is not or this
is?
SP. SP.
Okay, now let's take another example.
Okay.
Elephants never forget. Elephants never forget. Elephants never forget. Okay, the next one is?
All elephants.
We'll come to that. Elephants never forget. The next one is some creatures. Some creatures forget. Some creatures forget. Therefore, some creatures are elephants. Some creatures are elephants. Now,
we have to insert a copula.
Yes, I didn't share it in the class, the whole class. I do not know whether. Okay, for those of us who just come in. They were not there for the last class. We had something called as a format of a categorical proposition. Remember A-E-I-O proposition we spoke and we said they have a particular format. And the format was like this.
Quantifier.
Yes.
Subject. Copula.
Quantifier, subject, copula, yes.
Predicate.
And predicate. This is what we had done in the last class. For those who were not there, you can just go back and check it out. Quantifier refers to the quantity aspect. If you remember, A preposition said all. Universal preposition, there were two words. All or no. So every kind of preposition will have a quantifier. There was another which was sums. So this was A preposition, E preposition, I preposition, something else, and in any given preposition, S and P means a subject and a predicate. Our quantifiers were all no, some, and some not. Okay?
Ma'am.
Now look at the sentence given to you when you say elephants never forget.
But ma'am, we cannot. The sentence is completely wrong because you cannot come to a conclusion in this statement because one says never forget and the other one says forget.
Hmm.
So the middle term is also not the same.
Now we will come to distribution. Now it will take us to distribution. So let's look at an example without looking at any technical references and validity of the argument. Let's put it in order first. How many of you say the argument is already in order? Is the major premise, minor premise, conclusion there?
Yeah.
Is the major, is there?
Elephants never forget.
What was the conclusion given?
Some creatures are elephants.
Okay, some creatures are.
Creature is subject.
Yes, creature is subject and.
Elephant is the predicate.
And your first sentence was elephants never forget.
Never forget.
And then you said some creatures forget.
Forget is middle.
Then
yes, ma'am?
Yes, some creatures forget. So now you would have arrived in a different position of the middle term.
Okay.
Oh,
this is my conclusion. Are we there, all of us? This is our conclusion. So I got SP here. Where should this is correct? This is your. You have P M and this is S.
You know, isn't it compulsory to have the middle term as same?
Yeah, we have.
Forget.
Never forget and creatures forget. Now we come to what you. I know what you are trying to say, and you are right in what you are saying. But before we go on, I'm just on the position of the middle term. Did you see the middle term here? Okay. If you can recollect, the order of the middle term changed every time. In the first one, it was in this position. It was positioned like this. Are we right? Did we all arrive at this in the first one? Second one, I think we arrived at this. If I am...
SN, because SN. The first one was SN.
MP and bring it to
PM, SM, SP. No, we have to get it into PM, SM, SP. Always has to be a major premise, minor premise, and
yes, that's the standard format.
But it can be it can be middle and
middle can be anywhere.
Middle can be anywhere.
Okay, so not necessary. It has to be PM and MS.
No, it can.
So that's what I was showing you for example.
Now we've done three.
But major premise will have the predicate.
Now we did three examples. In this example, if you see your middle term is here. This one is for this one. This was for this one. And this is for this one. What was the first one? Can someone give me the positive?
That was the statement.
All lawyers are liars. Mr. A is a lawyer, therefore Mr. A is a liar.
So you see the middle term has been positioned differently. Can we see the middle term positioned differently?
Right.
In this it is positioned like this. In this it is positioned like this. In this it is positioned like this. Again like this. Are we clear? Now whenever the middle term changes its position, it is called a figure of a syllogism. So all syllogisms have something called a figure, and which is determined purely by the position of the middle term. I'm sorry for this technical. But that is how it is. But once you get this base, you can argue any of this. Are we there? So can I put this and show you what are the four positions? I'm sure all of you can give me the answer.
What is the practical application of all this?
Where is the application? No. Position of a figure. The figure of a syllogism is determined by the position of the middle term. Figure.
All students get an O. I am a student. I will get an O.
Yes, sir. Very bad.
That's a fact.
I've written all the conclusions. There are four possible ways of looking at the middle term.
Figure.
First figure. Figure 2. Figure 3. And figure 4. Four possible ways the middle term can occur. This is your major premise. This is your minor premise. And this is my conclusion. All of us are clear? Major premise, minor premise, conclusion. That's the standard form. Now, my middle term can occur as
first
year and
yes.
Always this is called the first figure. Okay?
Yes.
When the middle term occurs as in this position from right left to right, it is always figure 1. In figure 2, it will always occur in the extreme right.
You need to remember this figure in order.
Yes. Last
time. Sir, I do not know what kind of questions would be asked, but if I don't, when Meenal Ma'am will take lecture, you will very soon understand this will be more meaningful to you. So, validity of an argument is purely determined by the formal structure. And soon you will realize arguments can be formally invalid. With this rule, I'm just doing, at least I've passed on at least 6 rules to you, but I'm just doing 4 basic rules. Okay, then.
Ma'am, can we get these rules written?
Of course, oh. I've got it. I'll email it to Chandra sir and he will pass it. I've got some arguments also from daily. conversations. And then you see how you argue. Okay. Are we there? What will be the third position? Can someone tell me?
M this side at the end, and then M on the right.
Beginning with M.
Yes, beginning with M.
Both.
Now will that be? Last line.
Major premise ends with M, minor premise begins with M.
So it's like mirror image. Yeah.
Correct. Now, we've got four figures. So in figure one, what is it? If I were to use, it is the subject in the major premise and predicate in the minor premise.
It is subject in
the major premise and predicate in the minor. If we were to talk of second figure,
it is predicate in both the premises.
Yes. Third figure,
it is subject
in both the premise. And what happens in the last one?
Predicate in major premise, subject in minor premise.
Four figures done. So we are done with rules, we are done with figures. We are moving on to rule of distribution. Now what happens if an argument has more than three terms? Or if it has more than three propositions? It will lead to a fallacy. What is the standard form of a categorical syllogism? It should consist of two premises and one conclusion. If it has more than three propositions, in which, let's say there are four propositions, it's a fallacy. If it has less than three propositions, it's a fallacy. But the beauty of syllogism is this, that in our day-to-day conversation, we all use less than three propositions. For example, what is this?
Paperweight.
Glass.
A ball.
Glass ball.
All of us agree on what?
Glass ball.
Paperweight. All of us will agree on paperweight. Okay? How did we know that this is a paperweight?
Because we've been talking.
It has been a trend, it is used in this way.
Pardon?
It has been a trend, it is used in this way.
It is a trend that we have used it in a.
Seen it before.
We've seen it before is one, but somebody said it's a ball.
A glass ball.
A glass ball, more specifically. Somebody said immediately a paperweight. How did we arrive at this?
Green
colored
glass.
Okay, so now she's becoming more specific.
Glass ball is always used as a paperweight.
Pardon, sir?
Glass ball is always used as a paperweight, that's why.
So now,
oh. Glass ball.
That surface is there. No, with the base. It is not
a paperweight.
Confusion.
Conclusion, right? I heard you right. Conclusion or She said it's a conclusion. Okay. Now look at this. You can make this into an argument, or you, some are saying it's a vague argument. Look at this. Bill did not go to work this morning. That's my conclusion. On what basis am I saying that? Because he wore a sweater. Now we can't connect sweater and going to work. But then we gave another sentence where we said he never goes to work when he wears a sweater. So, no occasions are those, if I were to put it in a proper format, no occasions are those when Bill goes to work with a sweater.
Yes. But
he
some
has, now we come to the validity part of it, but now we are putting it in a structured form. What is the conclusion? Bill did not go to work this morning. That's a conclusion. On what basis? Because he wore a sweater. And how do you know just, so you say no occasions are those when Bill wears a sweater, he goes to work. So that's my premise. Actually, it's not, like you all said, it's a little vague, not very clear. But if you try to build it up, this is how it goes. Yes, it is a categorical syllogism because you definitely put no occasions are those when Bill wears a sweater, he goes to work. He has worn a sweater, therefore he has not gone to work. Are we clear on this concept of syllogism, how it works? Now, I'll give you four sentences.
Yeah.
Please put them in a proper standard form of a categorical proposition. What do I mean by categorical proposition? A-E-I-O. First one. First one is, not all that glitters is gold. Not all that glitters is gold. You're right, but there's no clarity in categorically saying that it's
you're using all and then you're saying no. Huh? Mm-hmm.
So what will it? All that glitters is not gold. Who can give me the answer? What kind of proposition will it be? All that glitters is not gold.
No, A.
When you say A, all that glitters is gold is A. Uh-huh. You're saying all.
Somebody is saying all that.
You're not using some, so it's not O and I.
I.
So what happens with this reduction of sentences, when we reduce sentences to their logical form, you bring in the specification. So you will now say, when there's no quantity specified, the statement is not clear, it is ambiguous. So you make it into some professionals are efficient. Okay, let's look at elephants never forget. What does that mean? What does that mean?
Most elephants never forget.
No, other animals than elephant never forget.
Other animals other than elephants
may forget.
No, it's
not specified. But sir, what he's saying is somewhat right. When you say elephants never forget, that means some elephants are, sorry, not elephants, some animals other than elephants can forget.
Yes,
you like that.
That is implied, yeah.
So it is not implied. Okay. So what are we saying? Elephants never forget. Some animals other than elephants may forget, may not forget, you are not sure of. So you can't say. But you can definitely say that no elephant forgets.
Yes.
Because the statement says elephants never forget. No occasions are those when elephants forget. Not a single elephant, that's what we mean by that. So whenever the word never occurs, it will become E. Whenever never occurs, it becomes. Whenever all and not is there, it becomes some not.
Ma'am, I add,
yes.
Though it makes sense, like, you know, when you read that, it's, you understand that some not, but how do you put it into an argument that all that glitters is not gold becomes some?
Okay. So it may differ in a context also. Suppose you are having a conversation with someone and they want to say all that glitters is not gold. So you ask him, what do you mean by all that glitters is? Not a single thing that glitters is gold? Or am I saying to some things that glitter are gold? What do I mean by when I say not a? So take this very good question you asked. Let us take two examples. All the perfume available in Arabia, all the perfumes available in Arabia cannot sweeten this little hand. All the perfume, not, I would now add, I said all the perfume in Arabia, now I am saying not all the perfume available in Arabia can sweeten this little hand. What does it mean?
None of the perfumes available.
Some
of the
perfume can sweeten.
No, not all.
None.
You said
none
of the
some.
Some.
Not all
of
some.
It, you said all of it put together cannot sweeten the hand.
Very true.
So none.
Now remember, the not all is a tricky word. Like I said, sometimes not all would mean no, and not all generally means some not.
Not all means
some.
Not all generally means some not. But in this particular example, like sir pointed out, it means no. Not a single perfume in Arabia can sweeten this little hand. Was put in a more complex way by saying not all perfumes in Arabia can sweeten this little. That means you're meaning the same thing.
But it can
some perfumes.
No, when you say not all, but it includes everything. No.
Not all, some.
Context, when you say not all, that's all that glitters is not gold also means nothing that glitters is gold. On the same context that you said, not all perfume of Arabia can sweeten the sand.
This brings us to two aspects of the word. Let's look at two aspects. Any given word, more than any given word has two aspects to it. One, the meaning aspect, and the other is the quantity aspect. and we have denotation. We did this in one of the classes earlier, connotation and denotation. What do I mean by connotation? Take the word glitter. What does it mean?
Shine.
Shine.
Ganesh.
Okay. With the mango bag. Okay, other than Ganesh, what else does it mean?
A fruit.
Any other aspect of mango can you
see?
No, but then we are getting into the physical properties of a mango.
How many are you referring to? So when you say denotation of a word, we mean quantity aspect. If I say students in the class, how many students are you referring to? All students or some students? Every word when you utter has two parts to it. One is the quality or the meaning of it. Take this paperweight. All of us understand the meaning of paperweight. Did anyone ask how many paperweight? No, because there is only one over here visible to us. So that was a commonsensical thing. We wouldn't ask how many paperweight. But if I say paperweight is made of glass, now you'll ask me, is every paperweight made of glass? No. No. Ask people who keep decorative paperweights. All types of paperweight. There can be a wooden piece, there can be a stone, there can be a stick. Anything that's small and heavy can be a paperweight. Sometimes our mobiles are used as paperweight. When we are working, we put up. Are we clear? So every word will have what is called as connotation and denotation. Now when I have not all put together,
Yeah.
सामने मैंने फिट आउट निकल रहा
है
चेतन मेरे को भी एक बोल
चेक हेलो
वाओ
मी है चेतन क्रीम आ गई
only a show. How about saying that wherever there is fire, there will be smoke?
Yes.
So we are
necessary. Some find the spokeless. Like Dilki Bhaiya.
The answer would be like this: all locations where there is smoke, there is fire. All locations where there is smoke are those where there is fire. Definitely we are not talking of animals though, sir. We We're not talking of creatures who have less of reason. We're not talking of those. Okay, are we clear? Did we get the lesson? Nobody is one who likes to be wrong. No. We need to have a proper quantifier and a subject. So when I say nobody, I'm not referring to anybody in specific. So I need to put some subject over there, and therefore we've introduced the word person. No person is one who likes to be wrong. So I've got my subject proper. When I say no one, I'm not referring to any specific subject. Like you said, why only person? It could be no animal likes to be wrong. It could be anything. No thinking being likes to be wrong. No animals or no birds, anything it could be. So we are trying to replace the one with a person. Okay, the next one. Mangoes are sweet. Very easy answer. Mangoes are sweet. Mangoes are sweet. It's already in the logical form. What is missing is quantifier. There's no quantity. You can't say all mangoes. Please remember thumb rule that whenever quantity is not specified, it will always be a particular preposition. Whenever quantity is not specified, you cannot assert anything about the whole class. You can only say something about a part of the class.
Some
mangoes are sweet. So you want a modifier?
Yes.
So the same sentence, when you say generally sweet, how many?
All
mangoes are generally sweet or some mangoes?
Majority. Most.
So then you are still referring to part. You are not referring to the whole class. And there it becomes.
Can you say there are some mangoes which are sweet?
So we don't need to say there are. So the format is quantifier as we said. The starting part of your sentence has to be either all, no, or some. Your proposition has to start in this form. It's a little rigid. And
why not use all in this case?
Because, as we said, professionals are efficient. How many professionals are? Will you say all?
Some professionals are efficient.
That's what. Obviously, you cannot assert about the whole class. You can always assert part of the class. Always. That's
practical approach you are doing.
It is a practical. Okay. The next one. Many decisions of the jury are not fair. I'm sure you all can give me the answer. Many decisions of the jury were not fair. Some decisions of the jury are those which were not fair. Some decisions
she got it.
All the jury. Some decisions of the jury are those which were not fair. And the last one, mobile phones are usually expensive. What will be the answer?
Some mobile phones are usually expensive.
Now the word usually indicates it at times. So you say at times, some occasions are those when mobile phones are expensive. Or you say some mobile phones are expensive. Are we clear till here? Anyone who, now can you tell me which proposition distributes what? We are moving on to now, syllogism and distribution of terms.
One second.
No one has sound clear, right? So we are now proceeding to distribution of terms. The second. What happened, Neha? They didn't give you a pen or what? Did you
no, ma'am. They don't have ma'am.
Oh. Tomorrow when Meenal ma'am speaks of Hetu Abhasa, possibly this is what you'll be talking about. Rule of distribution.
She speaks of what?
Hetu Abhasa. Of Indian logic. Okay. So let's look at rule of distribution. I want all of you to be clear on two things. Can someone give me the figures?
Yeah.
First figure,
second figure, third figure, and fourth figure.
Middle term subject. First figure, middle term subject, middle term, minor term predicate.
Minor premise.
Then both predicate.
Right corner.
Both predicate, both subject.
Left mirror.
First, major premise predicate.
Is he correcting what he's saying?
Yes.
Okay, the last
major premise predicate. Minor premise.
What do I fill up the rest with?
Subject, S and P.
Where I'll put the S?
On the top.
No, P will always come first.
P will always come on the right.
P will always come on the first proposition. So all this will be filled up with P.
Major premise will always come.
Always major premise is first. What will this be?
Nine.
Now can someone tell me A distributes what?
Subject.
All of you are sure of that. Anyone is not sure?
No.
We'll take his neighbor's help. A distributes what?
Subject.
E distributes what? No. I distributes what?
A, E distributes both.
So I.
I distributes none.
And O?
Predicate.
In any given argument, in any given argument, and you put it in a given argument, you will reduce it to a logical form of A, E, I, O, whatever the argument is. And then you will look at the distributed term. Let's take that example. What was the first example that you had taken down, sir? What was the first example that you already No, not that one. The earlier, when we did SPM, those guards. Okay.
All foods are colored.
Chetan is a lawyer. All lawyers
are liars. All lawyers are liars. Mr. Chetan is a lawyer. And therefore, Mr. Chetan is a liar.
No offense meant, do not take this. Okay. So we have.
Factually incorrect.
Now take that example of elephants.
Yeah.
That's an example of elephants.
Elephants never forget. Some creatures forget. Therefore, some creatures are elephants.
Okay, we are looking at which example was that?
Third one.
Okay, look at the third example. Third example.
Yeah.
All cats are animals.
Third one is elephants. Elephants never forget. Some creatures forget. Therefore, some creatures are elephants.
Okay, let's look at the first sentence. Is it in order? Major premise, minor premise. Major premise, minor premise, conclusion. Okay, what was the first sentence? Elephants never forget. What did we say? Never would indicate what? Universal
negative.
So you say no elephants.
Yes.
No elephants are those. Who forget? Okay. What's the next sentence given to you all?
Some creatures forget.
Creatures. Now I'm putting them in the logical format. Please remember that. I've got a qualifier, I've got a subject, I've got the copula and the predicate. Here also we said some creatures forget. Now we're going to put it in a format.
Are those who forget?
Are those who forget? And my conclusion is what? What's the conclusion?
Some creatures are elephants.
Some creatures are.
Creatures.
And where is my
elephant?
Elephants.
major premise.
I'm sorry, the pen is very.
Who is calling from?
Creatures is what? Which figure is it? Second. All of you like read second figure?
Yeah.
Because you've got PM, you've got SM,
yeah.
And you can conclusion SP.
SP.
So we are on figure 2. All of you agree?
Yeah.
It's figure 2.
Permanent?
No, not permanent.
Permanent.
Yeah. I'm just putting this symbol here. Striking
something is better than
so I put no over here, and I put some over here, and I put some over here. Now we put a tick mark on the term that is distributed. Where should I put the tick mark? He distributes both. I distributes none.
I none.
So where should I put my tick marks, please?
I none. So, yeah.
So cross on both.
Yes.
Ah.
So E, the device and tick mark on both. Yes.
All of you are clear what we
have done? Yes.
Yes. Okay. We identify the kinds of preposition there were. We said no elephants. We said what was given to us, elephants never forget. We reduced it to a logical format where we had the quantifier, the subject, the copula and the predicate. So that format was no elephants are those who forget. Then we came to the sentence which says some creatures are those that forget. What is the example given? Some creatures forget.
Some creatures forget.
Some creatures forget. So we put it in the logical format. What was the logical format? You got your quantifier, some creatures is the subject, are those is your copula, and forget is the predicate. Coming to the conclusion, we did the same thing. Some creatures are elephants. The same thing, we identified the minor term, major term, and the middle term, and we put it symbolically like this. Symbolically like this. No stands for this quantifier. P stands for elephants. M stands for middle term. S stands for minor term. M stands for middle term. In the conclusion, S stands for minor term and P stands for major term. We put the kinds of proposition. This was universal negative. We put no. This was particular affirmative. We put some. Conclusion is also. After this, what did we do? We identified the term that is distributed. And what we meant by distribution, whenever the reference is total, it refers to the entire class. Anytime it refers to a part of the class, it is said to be undistributed. And we said, wherever it is distributed, we will put a tick mark, and where it is not, we will put a cross. Did we do that? Yes. We put a tick mark wherever it is distributed. You put a cross where it is not. Now, as for the rule of syllogism, a term must be distributed. If it is distributed here, if a term is distributed in the conclusion, it must be distributed in the premise. What is the rule? If a term is distributed in the conclusion, it must be distributed here. Is there any such problem?
No.
No.
Okay, the rule of distribution says if there is a tick mark here, there should be a tick mark here. But if there is a cross here and there is a tick mark here, no problem. Are we there?
Distribution,
we meant, what did we mean by distribution? We said a term is said to be distributed when it refers to the whole class. Yeah. Actually,
I'll just call it.
Okay, do one thing now. You all write. Instead of me writing, you all can just write it up. Okay, let's. Are we there, in this particular example, the rule was followed. What is the rule? If something is distributed in the conclusion, it must be distributed in the premise. Was anything distributed here? No.
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 Okay? So there is no fallacy. The other rule is the middle term. I am talking of two rules of distribution. The first rule of distribution is the middle term must be distributed at least once. The middle term. What is the middle term? It is a linking term. It must be distributed at least once. Is it distributed here? Yes.
Yes.
Is it distributed here? Yes. Okay? Is it distributed here? Yes. The next rule is a term, if it is distributed in the conclusion, must be distributed in the premise.
Any one of them.
Any one. No, no. In their respective premise. The second. Okay, let's take. Will you quickly take down two more examples? Please write. All cats are animals, all dogs are animals. All cats are animals and all dogs are animals.
All cats are dogs.
All cats are animals and all dogs are animals. The next example.
So the conclusion, all cats are dogs.
Meaningless. Actually, it's meaningless. We'll soon realize why it is meaningless. Okay? The next one. All cats are animals and all dogs are animals. Therefore, all cats are dogs. Okay. The next one is, some diamonds are not precious stones. Some diamonds are not precious stones. And some carbon compounds are diamonds. Some carbon compounds are diamonds. Therefore, some carbon compounds are not precious stones. Some carbon compounds are not precious stones. Can someone give me the format of that argument? I mean the symbolic expression. What's the first one?
Some diamonds are not precious stones.
No, sir. So the first one.
Cats and dogs.
Cats.
Oh, sorry. All cats are animals.
I can't write. Can I use that word?
No, I cannot.
Cats are what?
All cats are animals.
Tell me which term does A distribute?
Subject.
Subject.
A distributes subject. So I put a tick mark on the subject. What is the subject of this proposition?
Dogs.
Dogs. What is the subject of this
cats.
Proposition?
Cats.
What's the subject of this?
Cats.
And where do I put a cross on the predicate? Because the predicate is not distributed. So I put a cross here, put a cross here, and I put a cross here. Now if you look at it symbolically, let's look at it symbolically now. Draw the circles. Okay? So we draw the circle for this, the cats fitting into the whole circle of animals. Sorry, dogs. Sorry. Dogs, the first one. The second one says all cats are dogs.
Animals.
Oh, sorry, all cats are animals. So I put that here. Can I link animals?
Sorry, I can.
There is a common link. What is the link? They're both animals. But can I link cats and dogs?
No.
I cannot link cats and dogs. Because the middle term, the animals is the middle term. It is not serving its purpose. What is the function of the middle term? To link the prepositions. It is not. So the rule of distribution says the middle term must be distributed at least once. If it is not distributed, it leads to a fallacy called undistributed middle. So what does the rule say? The middle term must be distributed at least once. If it is not distributed, it leads to a fallacy called undistributed middle. So here if you see, the middle term is not, though it appears correct. Technically, when you listen to it, you say obviously the conclusion has to be all cats are dogs. But if you look a little deeper, you will say it cannot be. Factually it is not, but otherwise it cannot be because the middle term is not distributed. Are we clear?
Yes.
Any doubt? Any doubt?
No.
So we've got two fallacies right now.
One distributed term is a term which represents whole class.
Yes.
But the animals is a whole class. And how we can cross it?
We were not there for our first lecture. When I say all students are smart, okay? I say all students are smart. I draw two circles. Tell me which circle will fit into what? I'm drawing two circles. This is a circle of students.
So smart about that.
Now, where am I referring to the whole class? To all students. Now, in this whole class of smart people, there might be others. There could be engineers, there could be lawyers, there could be other professionals, there could be businessmen. Anybody can fit in this smart class. Have I referred to the whole class of smart people?
All students here.
I refer to only the student community as a whole, but not to all smart people. And therefore, A distributes subject.
So, how we can connect here in animals?
Okay, let's look at it. I've got my animal circle. And who is fitting into that animal circle?
Dogs.
Dogs. So, this I'm referring totally. Therefore, I put a tick mark that A distributes its subject. In this animal circle, there could be other animals.
Yes.
When I say all cats are animals, I'm drawing another circle to say cats are also animals.
Yes.
Is the animal circle complete? No. It could have other animals.
Animals.
It could have goats, it could have cows, it could have buffaloes, pigs, anything could fit in over there. But it is not complete.
Wild
animal, any animal, we have not specified. And therefore it is not distinct. So it's not linking it. That's what I said. If you are not there for one class, this goes.
One circle.
Yes. Are we there?
Yes.
You got the answers. Let me confuse. One more example and just 5 minutes more and then we stop. Take down. Some spaniels are not good hunters. Some spaniels are not good hunters.
Spaniels.
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 Spaniels. What is the meaning of spaniels?
Dogs. Some spaniels are not good hunters.
Spaniels, right?
ESP.
No. S-P-A-N-I-A-L-S.
S-P-A-N-I-E-L-S.
Breed of dog.
E-L-S. Some spaniels are not good hunters. Some dogs are gentle. Some dogs are gentle. Some dogs are gentle. G-E-N-T-L. They are not very aggressive. Some dogs are not aggressive. Then, the next one. Some animals are dogs.
This is a conclusion.
No. Now comes your conclusion. Whether you will merge or you can merge, I do not know now. Let's look at the example. We have not given you the conclusion. See if you can arrive at it. The rule of structure says there should be only three prepositions. There should be only three terms. The rule of structure, the first rule. How many terms do you have here?
Four.
What are the four terms? What are the four terms?
Spaniels are gentle animals.
Spaniels, dogs,
good hunters. We say the first one. Some spaniels are good hunters.
Five terms.
That's a conclusion. How did you arrive at it?
Dogs appear twice. Animals will appear in the conclusion. Gentle will appear in the conclusion.
What happened to the hunter word?
Spaniels.
There is a place by gentle.
Dogs is a gentle.
It is a fallacious argument. You cannot arrive at a conclusion, sir, because you've left out one term. In a syllogistic argument, you should have the terms occurring twice. If they do not occur twice, and there should be only three terms, not more. How many terms are there?
Five.
Though which term has occurred twice?
Dogs.
And one more.
Only dogs.
But can't we say spaniel is also a dog, so can't we consider dogs appearing thrice?
No. You can. Depends on how you interpret. But if listening, keeping it to the, so that becomes a little, we'll take it up a little later, because you know what? There is a way of changing terms and bringing it to one word so that it becomes easier to understand. Right now we are on just the base. Okay? Any doubt?
We can leave the first sentence again.
If you ignore the first sentence, what he said is right. You can arrive at a conclusion. But I can't ignore. I've been given three sentences together. And there is no conclusion given. So I still cannot arrive at a conclusion because there is no linkage created. The last one. Some food items are nutritious. Some food items are nutritious. Some nutritious food is costly. Food is costly. Therefore, some, what will be the conclusion? Therefore,
some costly foods are nutritious. Some nutritious foods are.
Some food is costly. Some food items are costly.
Some food items are costly. Tell me if it is in an order of
no.
Major premise, minor premise. No. So what will be the order now? Change the order.
Some nutritious food is costly. Some food items are nutritious. Therefore, some food items are costly.
Yes.
Very good.
Okay. Now tell me which kind of prepositions are these? Which kind of prepositions are there?
Some food items. Some. All E. Not sorry, I.
All are I. All are I. Yeah. Which term is distributed?
I in N. None.
Okay. None of the terms
so
are distributed. Now if I have, I'll put it symbolically here. And with that we stop.
Pen then, ma'am. Ma'am, you got the pen.
Oh yes.
The mark.
Just tell me the SPM format now.
general term is second. Yeah.
Some nutrition
the predicate. Middle term is a predicate.
What's the word?
Nutritious.
Nutritious. Food items are nutritious. Okay, and then? What's the minor premise?
Costly. Sorry. No, no. Costly is the major premise, ma'am. And food is the minor premise.
Is it the same format? No. Some?
Some. P is M,
yes.
That's right.
Yes.
The second is sum, M is
M-P.
S.
S, M, S.
M, P,
S.
Ah, that's right.
Which figure is it?
SM. Ma'am, it was SM, MP, SP.
No, we corrected it, no sir. We brought in the logical form of major premise, minor premise, and conclusion.
MP.
Oh, yes. Change here. Costly has to do some costly food items.
Read out the
sentence. Some nutritious, so after
yes,
correcting it, it becomes some nutritious food is costly, some food items are nutritious, therefore some food items are costly.
So the second becomes the first line, the first line becomes second.
That is what we had.
Is it correct?
Yeah.
Yes.
Which figure is it? Which figure
the
is
last
it?
Last one.
Fourth figure. Which kind of proposition is it?
I.
None. What does I distribute?
None.
Where do I put my cross?
Everywhere.
Is my middle term distributed?
No.
So it leads to the fallacy of undistributed middle term. Let's draw a diagram and you will see. Yes.
The I thing says that it need not be distributed.
It doesn't say it need not be distributed. It simply states it's not distributed.
You can't play with them.
Again, you know the circles.
Yes. Tell me, how will I draw the circles? I have two intersecting circles. One will be, what was it? Nutritious, food and costly.
Nutritious.
And food and costly.
Costly.
And another was?
Food.
Food. No, sir, there are two things.
Second line here. What line?
Food, nutritious
food
and costly.
Food and nutritious.
Food.
Food items and nutritious. No. None of them are interested.
I can't say what is the conclusion that we arrived at.
Blank.
I think we had a negative sentence if I am not mistaken.
No ma'am.
No.
All affirmative. Can we arrive at any conclusion? I cannot. Because this section which is overlapping is one possibility. The second possibility is this one. And the third possibility is this one. And the fourth possibility is this one. So whenever there are more than one possibility, means your argument is invalid.
No.
Okay. Okay, we have to say okay now. Let's.
Whenever
there are more than one possibilities, an argument becomes invalid.
But how did you manage to draw these
three circles? No, sir, that's why I said, give me the sentence. I don't remember the sentence.
So I'll give the first one.
Yes, give me the
some first nutritious one. Food is costly.
Some nutritious food. Is costly.
Some food items are nutritious.
Food is nutritious.
Therefore,
some food items are costly.
Okay, let's draw a diagram for each of the sentences. Okay,
nutritious
for this
costly.
One, I will have intersecting circles costly and nutrition.
Yeah. Yeah. Food and
In between is the sum.
Yes.
Okay. This is what you're talking about. Okay.
This is what we are asking.
Right.
What does the next one say?
Food and nutrition.
Food and
some
nutrition.
Some food items are nutritious. Where should I draw the circle?
Both, no.
Why?
No, both are not in the circle.
Where can I draw the circle which says
close
to
N and
the
other? N co-intersecting.
No.
All these are speaking of some.
Some and other.
So if you're not considering the third sentence, it, you can make it on the left of N, intersecting N.
Yeah.
Because we are not considering the third sentence.
How many of you will agree that I can draw it like this?
No.
Is there any possible way of, yes sir, what's the other way of drawing?
Intersecting
I can draw it intersecting all three.
Yeah, because the second sentence is some nutritious food that costly.
Oh.
Food has to be nutritious and costly. Food and costly has to be because the conclusion comes.
some nutritious food. What was the first word? No.
I feel it should be like two circles. Food and nutrition. And
let us be clear on the terms. What's the first term?
Some nutritious food.
Some food items.
Some food items are new. Sorry, the first term is some nutritious food is costly.
Listen to what he's saying. He's got a valid point. He's saying some nutritious food are costly. That's my first sentence. What's my second sentence?
Some food items are nutritious.
Some food items are nutritious. That means when I'm talking of nutritious food, I'm talking of nutritious food also, I'm talking of food. Both.
Yes.
And therefore he says the diagram should be like this.
Yes. Okay.
It has to intersect, right? It has to intersect with nutrition, it has to intersect with costly, and it has to be independent also.
Yes.
And yet what happens? There are three possibilities. That the food may be nutritious, only nutritious.
Yes.
The food may be only nutritious. The food may be only costly.
It can be nutritious and costly.
It can be nutritious and costly. So the moment I got three conclusions from one set of sentences, three sets of, two set of statements, the argument will never be valid. Because the middle term is not linking them. Is the middle term not linking? When does the middle term link? It has to be like this.
Okay, ma'am, there's a very small observation here. She found out that this is actually MP and it's supposed to be that way.
Major Mumbai?
Yeah, so it is not the first figure. It is supposed to be the first figure.
Whatever you
know.
P U E S.
Figure what?
But still, that doesn't make any difference to the logic.
Why is it not? Why is it invalid? Because it violates the rule which says the middle term must be distributed at least once to create a link. It's not creating a link. If we were to simply change this, let's say we make it all.
Then there's a link here because it becomes a.
All nutritious food is costly. Some food is nutritious, and therefore some food is costly.
So, do the A sentence which has subject as the
middle term, and it gets distributed. Therefore,
yes.
It would agree.
I don't know how.
So then, if the conclusion is all. Conclusion will also change, right, ma'am?
S is minor term. P is major term.
So, all nutritious food is costly.
You gave the polymer,
some food items are nutritious. Therefore, all nutritious food are costly.
Some food items are costly.
Therefore,
P is the major term.
Major
is very high.
There's no distribution in the conclusion, but the major premise is distributing the middle term.
Yes.
So the rule is followed. The rule is what? At least once. In any of the premises. If it is not distributed, it leads to the fallacy of undistributed middle. Remember the example of animals.
You said that the middle term should be distributed at least one in any of the premises. The middle term never comes in the
country. Huh?
Doesn't come in the
country.
Thank you.
Yes,
we stop here.
Yes, ma'am.
And the next, I'll just email some examples. You all can solve it.
Yeah.
Yes. Please read and come next time. You may just check on the net. There's plenty of material available. There are all IS, all competitive exams make use of syllogism. Yes, all competitive exams make use of